在香港，说起夜生活，人们总是会想到兰桂坊。许多年轻人夜晚来到这里消遣、会友，享受自由自在的时光。而让这条小巷子享负盛名的，是有着兰桂坊之父之称的盛志文。这位在德国出生、在加拿大长大的犹太人，1969年就孤身一人来到香港创业。盛志文这个名字虽因兰桂坊而广为人知，但他初到香港却是做成衣外贸生意。上世纪六七十年代是香港纺织业发展的黄金时期，这让偶然到访香港的盛志文看到了商机。1975年，他在香港成立了自己的成衣公司 Cobuy。 1978年中国改革开放以后，不少香港制衣厂看到了内地更为廉价的原料和劳动力成本，纷纷迁至内地。盛志文也开始考虑在内地采购成衣，经香港销往海外。
In those years, Hong Kong had all the trading, all the companies were, factories were here, and mainland was just starting to do business with outside with foreigners at the time. And so we used to go to the mainland to search out different factories after we started Colby. And then in 1982,I started my first office in Changsha in Hunan. That was my first time with having an office.
上世纪八十年代初期，中国交通网络并不发达。在盛志文的记忆里，他从香港去长沙只有两种交通方式可以选择，一是搭乘火车从广州中转，再坐大约14个小时的过夜火车，而另外一种方式是搭乘老式的螺旋桨飞机，飞到湖南大约2个小时，但每个星期只有3趟航班，机票非常难买。
I still remember one time, one funny story. I came to Guangzhou and I got the last ticket, and so I was the last one to board the airplane. But there was no computers in those years, so actually all the seats were sold, even though I had a boarding pass. And I was thinking to myself, I have to sit 14 hours on a train. No, I said, no, I'm staying here. I played very dumb with my Western Guaylo face, you know. The stewardess, the girl, she took a small stool and put it in the center aisle. No seat belt, nothing. Okay, sit here.
八十年代的中国内地，很少能看到外国人的身影。盛志文所到之处，总是会收获好奇的目光。尽管面临着出行和通讯不便，但盛志文依然对中国充满好感。他喜欢中国人身上的天真和淳朴。
The people in China in those years were very, very innocent. You know, they did not have a lot of contact with the outside world. Of course, being a foreigner, many had never seen foreign face. And sometimes when I was walking in the street, some people would come up and they would want to touch my face. Yeah, it was really, really something very, very unique, very special. For me, it was... I loved it.
在不断打开内地市场的同时，盛志文在香港也开启了另一片天地。1981年，他在兰桂坊开了一家加州餐厅，白天是餐厅，晚上变身酒吧。这种经营模式在当时颇有创意。八十年代的香港经济腾飞，文娱产业欣欣向荣，当时的很多明星都是加州餐厅的常客，兰桂坊见证了香港文化的黄金时代。
We started to get many movie stars we came because there was not a lot of places. And the late Danny Chan, the singer, you know, used to come every day. Movie stars, Wang Fei, you know, all of them came to Lan Kwai Fung.
从加州餐厅开始，盛志文逐步向这条街上的业主收购业权，再融入不同风格的酒吧十四。香港最著名的酒吧及餐饮区在他手上诞生，盛志文由此获得了兰桂坊之父的名号。在盛志文眼里，兰桂坊不仅仅是一个娱乐场所，它更是体现了香港文化中的开放与包容。盛志文希望将这种文化带去内地。2009年，他在内地的首家兰桂坊落户四川成都锦江区，而后的几年里，兰桂坊在内地的版图不断扩大。如今，盛志文几乎每周都要去内地走走看看。现在的交通运输网络四通八达，绿皮火车和螺旋桨飞机早已成为他过去的回忆。中国不可思议的发展变化，也让盛志文对中国的发展模式有了自己的看法。
China needs to have this, the political system that it has right now. I know many Western countries don't understand that because they want to instill their way into China, but it works. The system, I've seen the people in China are happy. I've seen them, their life get better.
2008年，久居香港的盛志文放弃了加拿大国籍，拿了香港护照和回乡证，成了一个名副其实的中国人。
I was proud to be Chinese. My nationality and my passport says Chinese. Oh, I really feel more Chinese than I do. I might not have the face. I still remember the immigration officers, when I went to apply.Wow, we're so happy. I was the only white face, standing in line with many people with their babies. I was just used to, but it was a wonderful feeling.
午夜时分的兰桂坊依旧熙熙攘攘。回望过去的40年，盛志文看着这条小路从冷冷清清一路成为香港夜生活的地标。正如他一路看着中国翻天覆地的变化，这让这位长着一副西方面孔的中国人对未来充满信心。
I've watched this, the opening up in the last 40 years. It's been dramatic. It's not another country in the world that has changed so many people, moving them from the farms to the cities, short a period of time. And even those people living on the farms, I remember going out to some of the farmlands and some, and people didn't have electricity. It was quite primitive. And then suddenly you go back to the same place and they have a nice little house and the children going to school. Some of the parents are working in maybe another city. So for me, reform just is about making people's lives better. And that's what I've seen China do.The leaders over the time have made China, the Chinese have a much better life. And in the world, mainland China will be number one. It is already an economy number two in the world. But I believe it'll definitely become number one in the not too distant future.